I agree with my views, but we have a liberal message from such a ascendant progressive politologist like Mermin Aknurijayan. Actually, today I want to discuss a few political events that happened in the recent political life of United States of America. Well, actually, recent statement of that United States Senator Barbara Boxer, Democrat from California, about jobs plan, President Obama's jobs plan not passing the Senate is wrong. I believe that the job plan President Obama been approved by Congress, vote went through partisan lines, you know. 50 Democrats in U.S. Senate voted for the job plan, and 48 Republicans voted against the job plan. So it, this job plan, President Obama, Democrat President Obama job plan has passed by simple majority. If Senator Barbara Boxer mentioned the fact that she didn't recognize simple majority and demanded simple majority and like 10 more votes from Republicans, it's actually it's a false pretense. It's a false pretense, and I believe that Senator Barbara Boxer is simply a corrupt and deluded person if she doesn't recognize simple majority of United States voting system. If she doesn't recognize that job plan been adopted by the 51% of 51% of the Senate majority in terms of a tie break will be done by Democrat Joe Biden, Vice President of the United States of America. And I believe that actually Ms. Barbara Boxer is just a bright example of a corruption that governs American politics. She's been in her job since too long. She received too many illegal donations from wealthy people, not to raise their taxes. And she has corrupted the rest of some of the Democrats and some of the Republicans. And I believe that the freedom limit to parliamentary activity, to congressional terms, it must become a law in order to prevent corruption in the United States Congress. And I believe that complete enforcement of the $2,400 limit for donation for a physical person should become actually a viable instrument in terms of eliminating corruption in United States Congress and putting into corrupt officials, corrupt elected representatives and senators who take who violate those federal limits of $2,400. Actually, strictest method enforcement of federal laws of campaign finance laws, you know, is actually a vital instrument to eliminate corruption in the United States Congress. And I believe federal attorneys should actually prove the independence of judicial power, its ability to fight corruption and prosecute any corrupt legislator, you know, any corrupt American president or member of executive cabinet of President Obama on corruption charges. It will be proof that the judicial power is capable to prosecute corrupt elements, including President Obama and corrupt federal legislators, because who don't care to raise wages and want workers to live in poverty. And we don't want any business. We want themselves to live like royalty, like aristocrats, who steal the working class people and like bloody parasites, don't care about establishing a living minimum wage of $10 an hour. The only thing that what corrupt legislators, both Democrats want to do, is just ripping off the public, fool around people with popular demagoguery, and they just don't want to establish a living minimum wage. President Obama personally refused to establish a living minimum wage during his electoral campaign in the year 2008. During one of I watched him saying that he refused to raise minimum wage, because he was a corrupt and reactionary politician. He received corrupt illegal bribes of $90 million from mobsters, from Chicago mobsters. This guy did a book fee for his autobiography, Audacity of Hope. But I might say that President Obama too should face impeachment, should be impeached and convicted in U.S. Congress for selling his senatorial seat for $90 million to so-called Senator Burris, who actually illegally occupied that senatorial seat while being appointed by the corrupt and convicted ex-Illinois governor Rod Blagojevich. And I predict that President Obama will win the second term as a Democrat, easily beat Mitt Romney or whoever, Republican frontrunner, during next year elections, but he will be impeached and convicted in U.S. House of Representatives and convicted in U.S. Senate on charges of corruption or illegally taking bribe of $90 million. This guy did a fee for his autobiography book at Audacity of Hope. So the sorrow fate, of that corrupt Illinois governor, Rod Blagojevich, who had been convicted on 17 charges of corruption, extortion, and racketeering, along with his narco-mafia's government, will occur to President Obama, who actually erstwhile cocainist, his former cocaine abuser, and he's as corrupt as his cabinet is, and should be convicted, impeached and convicted, and that call on both Republican and Democratic congressmen to file article of impeachment against the corrupt President Obama and impeachment on the charge of taking bribes of $90 million. And he should be responsible, and America will become will stay a republic and will stick to its Republican principles of American democracy as long as the laws will be enforced and the corrupt official brought to justice, and social justice will be established as well. And I claim was Democratic congressman to raise tax against wealthy 50%, not just 5%, like they're trying to say, like right-wing MSNBC press nowadays says, but 50% against corrupt million wealthy corporations and rich people who actually descendants of slave owners. The only way we could amass a fortune was committing ruthless exploitation of their own patents, ruthless exploitation of slaves, and the only source of that wealth is ruthless exploitation of slaves in American history, those fortunes, those large fortunes of those corporations and wealthy individuals come only from ruthless exploitation of slaves in southern plantation of Alabama and Georgia, and ruthless exploitation of American workers, coal miners in Pennsylvania. It's all criminal. It's all never been, none of those fortunes are legal. Never been. Like fortune of Morgan, they've never been legal. It's a crime. It's a series of crime and offenses and corruption that create any fortune. And the sooner federal congressman will be able to tax this illegal wealth 50% and take away that wealth and redistribute it, the better off we will be. Otherwise, American Revolution will wipe them out.